Hello friends, myself Binali Mane, working as a lecturer in Arts, Science and Commerce College Ramanagar of Rey Shikshan Sanstha. Today we are discussing about basics of cost accounting. So firstly, it should note that cost accounting is one of the important branch of account which is useful for manufacturing organizations. So cost accounting is concerned with recording, classifying and summarizing costs for determination of costs for product or services, planning and controlling and reducing such cost, and furnishing of information to the management for decision making. According to the Institute of Cost and Management Accounting, cost accounting means the process of accounting for the cost from the point at which expenditure incurred to the establishment of its ultimate relationship with cost centers and cost units. In its widest sense, it embraces the preparation of statistical data, the application of cost control methods, and the ascertainment of profitability of activities carried out or planned. So, while studying the cost accounting, it is important to study or to know the objectives of cost accounting. The basic objectives of cost accounting are ascertainment of costs, establishment of cost, cost control, cost reduction, determination of selling price, facilitating preparation of financial and other statement, providing basis for operating policy. In cost accounting, there are some basic terminologies of cost that are, firstly, cost. Cost means the amount of expenditure incurred on a particular thing. Or cost means total expenses which are incurred on producing particular product or a unit. Another concept or another terminology of cost is costing. Costing is the technique and process of ascertaining the cost. Or costing means the process of ascertainment of cost. The third concept of or terminology of cost accounting is cost accounting. The application of cost control method and the ascertainment of profitability of activities carried out or planned. The another terminology is cost control. Cost control means control of costs by management. Job costing. Job costing helps in finding out the cost of production of every order and thus helps in ascertaining profit or loss made out on its execution. The management can judge profitability of each job and decide its future course of action. Batch costing. Batch costing production is done in batches and each batch consists of number of units. The determination of optimum quantity of constitute and economical batches is all the more important. So, while studying the cost accounting, elements of costs are important. Basically, the cost includes three basic elements that are material, labor and expenses. Each that element includes direct and indirect things that are direct material, indirect material, direct labor, indirect labor, direct expenses and indirect expenses. So material. Material means the substance from which the finished product is made is known as a material. Direct material is one which can be directly or easily identified in the product. Indirect material. Indirect material is one which cannot be easily identified in the product. Labor. The human efforts required to convert the materials into finished product is called labor. Laborers are also divided into two types, direct labor and indirect labor. The direct labor, the laborers which are directly working on the machines or direct working in the factory are the direct labor. Indirect labor, likewise indirect material, the laborers which cannot be easily identified or which cannot be directly related with the production process, that are the indirect labor. And the third element of cost is expenses. Expenses are those expenses other than the materials and laborers. That expenses are direct expenses and indirect expenses. Direct expenses are those expenses which are directly related with the production process of a particular unit or a product. And indirect expenses, the expenses which are indirectly related with the production process, means the expenses which are not incurred in the factory or not incurred at the time of producing a particular product, but they are indirectly related with the production process. So after detailed study of elements of cost, on the basis of these elements of cost, we can prepare the cost sheet. While preparing the cost sheet, we have to use these three basic elements, that are direct material, direct wages and direct expenses. With these three elements, we can ascertain the prime cost of a particular product. If we add factory overheads in that prime cost, we can use work in process of opening and closing work in process in prime cost. After this calculation, we can get the works cost. In work cost, we can add the office and administrative overheads. That office and administrative overheads includes office rent, insurance, cleaning office, cleaning charges, office salaries, etc. So, after adding office and administrative overheads to the work cost, we get the cost of production. In cost of production, we should add the opening stock of finished goods and less closing stock of finished goods. After that, we can get the amount of cost of goods sold. In that amount of cost of goods sold, we should add selling and distribution overheads. In selling and distribution overheads, we can show the expenses incurred or overheads incurred on showroom expenses, salesman salaries, commission, bad debts, advertisement expenses, etc. So, after adding this selling and distribution overheads to the cost of goods sold, we get the cost of sales. And in that cost of sales or total cost, while subtracting these total costs from the sales value, we can get the net profit or net loss which is incurred on a particular product or particular unit. Thank you.